We're going to solve this problem together, but first, try it on your own. You can do it. Okay, so let's think about this problem. They say a line contains the points 4, 2, and 0, negative 1. They want to know what is the equation of this line. So the first thing I'm going to do is find the slope. And the slope is the difference of the y values, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And I'm just going to label my point 4 is going to be x1, y then has to be y2 has to be y1. I just mean that I could have made 4 x2, but if I did, I've got to make 2 y2. I've got to make them be the same, have the same subscript. And then that means that 0 here is x2 and negative 1 is y2. Now I just plug the formula in, y2 minus y1. So negative 1 is y2, y1 is 2, so it's negative 1 minus 2, divided by 0 minus 4. Negative 1 minus 2 is negative 3. 0 minus 4 is negative 4, so our slope is negative 3 divided by negative 4, which is positive, and m is 3/4. So actually, I know already the answer's got to be B. It's the only one where the slope, which is the coefficient of x, is 3/4. But let's just go a little bit further so that if we had to find negative 1 here, that's the y-intercept, we understand how to do that. Because we've got the slope, how do you find the intercept? Well, y is equal to mx plus b if you're dealing with a line. This is a general template for your line. Y and x are left as variables in general. They're the different points that satisfy the line. We just found the slope. Now we want to find b, which is the y-intercept. So there's lots of ways to do this, of course, but I like to then essentially plug in my points to find b. And oops, what am I doing? Okay, so, sorry. The point 0, negative 1, think about where that point is on the graph. If x is 0 and y is negative 1, it's the point here, right? This is 0, negative 1. That is the y-intercept, which is where the negative 1 comes from. But let's pretend we don't have that information. We only know the slope and the point 4, 2. At this point in your equation, all you need to do is plug in the point 4, 2. Because 4 is x and 2 is y, right? So 2 equals 3/4 times 4 plus something. 3/4 of 4 is just 3. And 2 equals 3 plus something. Well, subtract 3 from both sides, and you'll see that b equals negative 1. So that's a third way of dealing with it. Anyway, they gave you the y-intercept here. All you need to do is find the slope and match the equation. But that was another workaround in case you didn't have that information. Thank you.